So here's another example for normal stress. This particular problem, we're given with a homogeneous rigid bar, AB. This one, which is supported by cables of different materials on both ends. So at point A, the left side, you have a bronze cable supporting the bar. And then at the other side, we have a steel cable. So we're given with the following data. So the limiting stress for steel, the sigma S, is 120 megapascals. For bronze, we have 90 megapascals. And so notice the difference. We have steel has higher strength compared to bronze. So that's why we have a greater limiting stress here for steel compared to bronze. No? We're also given with the mass of the bar, 800 kilograms. No? So before we start with this, or later, no? First, the required for this problem is that we have to find the smallest area for each cable so that these limiting stresses are not exceeded. No? So we're going to find AS and AB. No? So before we start computing for the required values, we just have to simplify this one. So this can be equal to Newton per square millimeters. This one is 90 Newton per square millimeters. And since this is given as mass, and then we're dealing with forces, we have to translate this into weight. You know that weight is just mass times acceleration due to gravity. So we have 800 kilograms times 9.81 meter per second squared. This kilogram times meter per second squared is just Newton. So we have 7848 Newtons. So this is now your weight. So this is force as your weight. So solution, again, we're solving here a normal stress problem. Our working equation is just sigma is just P over A. And then we have two cables. So we have for steel, it's just PS over AS. And then you have for bronze, we just have B equals PB over AB. So we're given with the sigma stresses. The P, we can find this PS and PB using the equation of equilibrium. And then we have the A, which are required values now. So using equilibrium, first we isolate the rigid bar. You have the weight here, of course. Now, so in your statics, when you have a symmetrical area, your weight is always concentrated on the midsection. So this is W, which is equal to 7848 Newton. Then you have the forces PB and PS. So these are the forces, internal forces in your bronze and steel. So you can do summation of forces along Y. Summation of forces along the Y axis equals zero. You will have PB, since it's symmetrical, PB and PS. So it's equal to PS. It's just 1/2 of 748 Newton, which is equal to 3924 Newtons. So this is PB and PS. So then substituting the values for PB and PS in your original equation, we can now have for area S, so this one becomes AS just equal to PS over sigma S. It's just equal to, your PS is now 3924 Newton divided by your sigma S, which is 120 Newton per mm square. So this cancels out the N, your mm square goes into the numerator. So AS equals 43.9 ano, it's 32.7 millimeters square. So this is the required area for steel. So a similar procedure, we have the area for bronze, we have the PB over sigma B 90, no, it's 3924 divided by 90 newton per, again this one cancels out, the mm goes to the numerator. We have AB is equal to 43.6 millimeter square. No? You can see the difference because our steel is much stronger compared to our bronze. That's why we need a smaller cross-sectional area for steel, no? Compared to our bronze, which is 43.6 greater than your bigger than your steel. So back to our problem. So this one is a smaller area, this one has a bigger cross-sectional area. So again, this is straightforward, just have to get the P because these are given, then you can solve for the required areas. So that's it.